clean the threads on the rotor shaft to remove any old thread locking material. Install the same thickness of impeller adjusting shims as previously removed on the rotor shaft. Install the impeller key in the shaft keyway. Align the impeller keyway and press the impeller onto the shaft until it seats firmly against the adjusting shims. After the impeller is installed, coat the threads of the rotor shaft with Loctite thread locker number 242 or equivalent compound. Install the impeller washer and nut, and torque the impeller nut to 20 foot-pounds, 240 inch-pounds or 8 meter-kilograms. After the impeller has been properly positioned, check for free rotation. Correct any scraping or binding before further reassembly. Inspect and thoroughly clean the suction casing and its gasket surface. Install the gasket. Then install the suction casing over the motor housing studs and secure with the nuts previously removed. There should be a clearance of 3/1000ths to 10/1000ths of an inch, 7/100ths and 25/100ths millimeter, between the suction casing and the face of the impeller. Reach into the suction casing with a feeler gauge to measure this clearance. If the impeller clearance is not within specified limits, remove the suction casing and the impeller, then add or remove impeller adjusting shims as required. Reinstall the impeller and suction casing and recheck clearance. Inspect the strainer assembly for cracks, distortion, or erosion, and replace it if defective. Position the strainer squarely on the shoulder of the suction casing and secure with the Nylock cap screws. Make sure that the strainer seats properly against the shoulder of the suction casing. Check the manual for lubrication requirements before putting the pump back into service.